Hey there, I'm Tori Beach, and I am a solo wedding videographer. One of the most important moments of the day is probably when the groom sees his bride for the first time. So I want to walk you through how I shoot a first look as a solo videographer. To be able to capture the groom's face when he sees his bride for the first time, and vice versa, when the bride sees her groom, it's just a very sweet moment that I want to make sure that I'm standing in the right place at the right time to capture those moments. And it really does just take coordination with the photographers and communication, as well as knowing what your angles should be. A lot of times the first look is rushed, so I try to make it as simple as possible for me to be able to get the shot that I need without a whole bunch of time trying to set up gear. So I tend to shoot with just one camera. Usually the groom will stand with his back towards the bride as she walks towards him. So what I like to do is to stand in front of the groom and get his face as you see the bride approaching from the back. After I get that shot of him, I move to the side. I like to get it so that she can either walk into frame or I'm seeing her from a little bit of her shoulder and the back of her, but I've got a really clear shot of him. Now, usually when we are setting up the groom, we tell him, turn towards your left or turn towards your right. However he turns and faces us first. So we always get his full body as he comes around. That's really important too, because you won't miss any moments. Once he turns around and you get that first aha moment, I like to hold it to see what he does. Does he rush to hold her? Does he stand there and just smile at her? Whatever his genuine first emotion is, I really hold on that as long as I can. But then also reading the moment and knowing when that moment has passed and when you have a window of time to move and get a different angle to make it a little bit more dynamic of a scene. I try to move and capture a little bit more of a close-up shot or sometimes a wide shot. However, be careful with your wide shots because the photographers are just buzzing all around this. So they're more than likely going to step into your shot. Even if they don't mean to, if it's wide, it's hard for them to get the shots that they need while keeping everybody out of your shot. Believe me, these go a lot faster than I think a lot of people think. So if you can't get a lot of angles in, as long as you got that one look, you're good, because then you can edit in all the other staged, posed, or playful shots that you get once the photographers start coaching them. Now, here's a trick that could save you a lot in the editing. I like to sometimes shoot the first look at 60 frames per second, or you could even do 30 and slow it down just a hair. Being able to take a moment and put it into slow motion, you can have shot something that was really only 10 seconds of something that was good. But if you're shooting it at 60 frames a second, you can almost double it. So now that 10 seconds has become 20 seconds, and that moment seems like it's suspended in time. It's a little bit more romantic. Slow motion can be your saving grace, especially if you're only shooting with one camera. I've had a bride who's jumped the gun and she's called his name before any of us are ready. So I'm mid-move in trying to capture, you know, get ready for his reaction. So having that slow motion does sort of help give it that feeling of suspended in time. It's just slow and it's beautiful and people don't really care that it's moving a little bit. The first look, it can be a little bit daunting, but as long as you take your time where you can and focus on the moments where that person who is seeing the bride turns around for the first time, as long as you focus on that person and you're not trying to do something crazy at the moment, you're most likely gonna get it just fine. What questions do you have for me? What suggestions do you have for a video on solo wedding videography? I'd love to know, so please feel free to leave all comments and suggestions in the comment section below. Thanks so much.